Boeing began to develop a new aircraft after the success of the Boeing 727. The Boeing 727 series had become the best-selling aircraft of the 1960s. Looking at the market, airlines wanted a bigger version of the 727 and asked Boeing if it could improve on the efficiency of the 727-200s. The manufacturer offered two concepts. The first was a longer Boeing 727-300 that would have the advantage of being built within 5 years with added seats. The second was a newer concept aircraft developed from the ground up called the 7N7. When Boeing released details of the 7N7 and how it would take advantage of newer technologies like high bypass turbofan engines and lighter weight materials, airlines reconsidered their options. Delivery of the first Boeing 757-200 was on December 22, 1982 to Eastern Airlines. The Boeing 757 would go on to fill the middle of the market role for airlines around the world. This would be routes that had high demand but not enough to warrant the wide-body Boeing 767. When the ETOPS was changed to allow twin-engined aircraft to fly over the Atlantic, many airlines chose to operate the Boeing 757 from North America to Europe. They would fly to smaller cities and allow airlines to carve out lucrative tourist routes without flying through hub airports, mainly like London. Thanks for watching, and please consider subscribing to the channel.